The government employees in Tamil Nadu are persisting with their indefinite protest programs from February 1. They have been hitting the roads and courting arrests, but the government has remained idle and insensitive. After a week, the employees under the Joint Action Committee of Teachers Organization and Government Employees Organization started a 72-hour long relay hunger strike from February 8. The demands include a long-pending issue on the abolition of contributory pension scheme implemented in 2004, the promise of late Chief Minister J. Jayalalitha on bringing back the old pension scheme has remained unfulfilled, the Tamil Nadu Government Employees Association alleged. The government is alleged of providing only settlement during the retirement of the employee.
We, the Tamil Nadu Government Employees, under the banner of Tamil Nadu Government Employees Association, is protesting for the demanding scrapping of new pension scheme. And the demand is not new. We are fighting for scrapping of this new pension scheme for the past 2 decades, since its introduction during the Vajpayee regime. In Tamil Nadu, the new pension scheme was introduced by the late Chief Minister J. Jayalalitha from 1/4/2003, while the central government has implemented the scheme from 1/1/2004. The new pension scheme is nothing but a thrash, and the government employees completely denying and taking away the pensionary social security. In Tamil Nadu, though it is called contributory pension scheme, Tamil Nadu government is neither granting the old pension nor the new pension to the government employees, and they are giving only a settlement during their retirement. During the elections, last assembly elections, Jayalalitha promised to look into this matter and to restore the old pension scheme to the government employees of Tamil Nadu. Yet, the government, which is headed by Edappadi Palaniswami, which is claiming itself as Amma's government, is not at all heeding to this demand. Not only heeding its demand, but also refuses to at least to negotiate the demand with the striking employees.
The vacancies in the government departments have continued to increase over the last decade, with around 4.5 lakh positions remaining vacant. The AIADMK government also increased the retiring age of the employees to 59, citing the COVID-19 pandemic delivering a deadly blow to the aspirants, since the unemployment is also remaining high.
Postponed their financial burden, they have increased the age from 58 to 59, which will completely taking away the job opportunities of the youth who are mostly unemployed. And it is absolutely to be withdrawn by the government. That is the demand of the Tamil Nadu Government Employees Association.
The government has not withdrawn the disciplinary actions taken during the 2019 protest after the Jakto Geo withdrew the week-long protest after the request of the Chief Minister. The government is also refusing to negotiate with the protesting employees, forcing them to intensify their protest in different forms.
In earnest good faith, reposing on a Chief Minister's assurance, we withdrew the strike and returned to work. Yet, government foisted cases on our leaders and initiated departmental disciplinary proceedings. For the past 2 years, we were demanding to withdraw all the cases and to drop all the charges framed departmentally. The coordinator of Jakto Geo and president of the SOL, president of TNGA, was victimized on his day of superannuation was suspended from service. Tamil Nadu Government Employees Association and Jakto Geo represented n number of times to government to withdraw all the cases, including against our state president M. Subramanian. Yet, government didn't heed to the demand for the past 2 years, and at the eve of elections to gain electoral gains, now Edappadi Palaniswami unilaterally getting some representation from the leaders who have not at all participated in the either in the strike or in the any agitations or put forth any demand, received a representation and announced unilaterally that they are withdrawing all the cases, which is completely fraud on government employees. And we completely, they have treated the agitating employees in utter contempt and disdain.
Thank you.